God, our Creator, has stored within us great strength and ability. And now with a prayer song, let's invoke the Almighty's blessings to develop these powers.
Maitrim bhajata akhila hrudyetrim. Maitrim bhajata akhila hrudyetrim. Maitrim bhajata akhila hrudyetrim. Atmavadeva paranabhi pashyada. Atmavadeva paranabhi pashyada. Yuddham tyajada spardham tyajada. Tejada pareshva kramamakramanam. Tejada pareshva kramamakramanam. Maitrim bhajata akhila hrudyetrim. Janani prithvi kama dukhaste. Janani prithvi kama dukhaste. Janako devah sakala dayalo. Janako devah sakala dayalo. Damya dadatta dayadvam janata. Damya dadatta dayadvam janata. Shreyo bhuyat sakala janana. Shreyo bhuyat sakala janana. Shreyo bhuyat sakala janana.
I invite the be-all and end-all of this institution, our manager, Very Reverend Dr. George Nyarakunnel, to welcome the gathering.
Your Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Your Excellency Bishop Joseph Kallarangad, Honorable Finance Minister Sri K. M. Mani, Sri M.M. Jacobsa, former Governor, elected representatives of the Jilla, Block and Gram Panchayats, guests, friends, benefactors, professors, students, and everybody who is present here. We are extremely fortunate and privileged to be able to welcome, sir, you, the former President of India and one of the most distinguished scientists Mother India has ever given birth. We have been eagerly waiting for this day. We eagerly wait to listen to your words of wisdom and erudition. Hearty welcome, sir. His Excellency Joseph Kallarangad is a patron, the spirit of guidance and God's blessing for us. Cordial welcome, Your Excellency. Honorable Minister K. M. Mani is our best friend and benefactor. Hearty welcome, sir. M.M. Jacobsa needs no welcome. He is a part and parcel of this institution. Hearty welcome, sir. Mr. Joseph Varakan, member of the Kerala Assembly, is here. Hearty welcome, Joseph, sir. May I welcome the elected representatives of the Jilla, Block and gram panchayats, former managers of this college, distinguished guests, PTA president, trustees, guests, professors, students, and everybody, hearty welcome to all. I wish you all a good day for you, and have a nice day. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Father.
Let me call upon His Excellency, Mar Joseph Kalaringat, our patron and spiritual guide, to deliver the presidential address.
Your Excellency, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Honorable Minister Sri K.M. Mani, Honorable Ex-Governor Sri M.M. Jacob, Very Reverend Father Dr. George, Dr. Jose, respected members. We are at Mar Agustinos College. Augustine was a genius. There is a well-known verse from him in Latin, Num amamus aliquid nisi pulchrum. That means, it is not possible to love what is not beautiful. This is a beautiful college with excellent infrastructure, very smart students, erudite staff, and a brilliant manager. With 13 different courses, Mar Agustinos College stands as a front runner and a trendsetter in the field of a self-financing education. In the nation-building process, the contributions of the Syrian Christian Catholic community is very outstanding. Education is an integral part of our church life and ministry. Churches and schools exist side by side. Evangelism and education go hand in hand. Since the handing down of the deposit of faith to successive generations is of paramount importance to Christian churches, all the churches invest heavily, both emotionally and economically, in the formation of young minds. No wonder the contribution of Christian churches to improve the educational sector in India is crucial. Democratization of basic education, still a desideratum in many places across the globe, has become a reality in a few Indian states, especially in Kerala. Church-run schools and colleges have widened the educational base progressively, incorporating women, Dalits, and persons with disabilities. Education in India used to be the preserve of wealthy, urban, high-caste men only. The whole scenario took a turn for the better with the involvement of the Christians, especially the Syrian Catholic Christians, in the field of education. I am extremely proud of, amidst all of you, especially in the presence of our Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. As President of the Indian Republic, Dr. Kalam had been a source of motivation for the whole nation. Dr. Kalam is a luminary from the spiritual galaxy of India, a dynamic visionary, an administrator with multi-management skills, a scholar of deep and sound knowledge, person of prayer and meditation. I am much delighted that Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, noted for his nobility of mind and firm faith in God, has come over to Ramapuram to dialogue with our college students. His Excellency is always interested in sharing ideas and intellectual property with others. Dr. Kalam is a great inspiration to all the youth of India. I have gone through some of his books like Wings of Fire, Turning Points, Ignited Minds, India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium. All these books are meant for inspiring our youth, for unleashing the power within them. Today, he will interact with our students here. He believes that sharing knowledge empowers education, and knowledge will lead to creativity, righteousness, and courage. This will bring beauty, as I said in the beginning, in the character, harmony in the home, order in the nation, and peace in the world. I conclude saying, dear Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, we are honored and we are humiliated by your presence. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Lordship.
Great deeds are the fruits of great thoughts, and thoughts emanates from great dreams. May I welcome the dreamer of great dreams, our esteemed chief guest, His Excellency Bharat Ratna Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, for the inaugural address, which will be followed by the much awaited event of the day, the interactive session with the students.
Ramapurathe ella janangalukkum vidyarthigalukkum enda namaskaram. Friends, I would like to greet Reverend Father Mark Joseph Kalirangar and Honorable Sri K. Mani, Minister, Honorable Minister, Honorable Dr. M.F. Jacob, Very Reverend Father George Nyanakunni, and Dr. V.J. Joseph, and all the students, teachers, and all the particularly student community of Mar Augustine Doss College, my greetings to all of you. Friends, I am indeed delighted. I have prepared my talk for the students. I think students are all sitting outside, or you are here. How many students are there? Lift your hand who are students. Students, okay. Not bad, good number, you are there, okay. So I was thinking whether I am addressing the students, so I'm happy now. And the people who are sitting outside also, I hope they will hear my talk. Friends, I'm indeed delighted. And also interact with the students of Mar Augustine College, Ramapuram. My greetings to all of you. I am very happy to know that this place, Ramapuram, has a great association with many events and people across different religions and history. It also celebrated the birthplace of ancient and modern history luminaries. Of late, Blessed Kunjachan, a Catholic priest, has an indelible mark on the social system of the place, both as a social reformer and champion of the marginalized. My greeting to the people of Ramapuram and the parents and the teachers, students of Mar Augustinos College at Ramapuram. When I'm with you, I would like to share a few thoughts on the topic, Education Empowers to Fly. Education, what is the topic? Education empowers you to fly. Education empowers you to fly. Since I am the midst of students and faculty members of Mar Augustinos College at Ramapuram, I would like to share my experience with teachers and the students, of course, in educational institution. I had the privilege, long ago, I had the privilege of studying in Swatsai School, Ramanathapuram, Tamil Nadu, where the medium of education was in Tamil, my mother tongue. My teacher, Reverend Ayathirai Solomon, was an ideal guide for an eager young mind that was yet to uncertain the possibilities and the alternatives that lay before it. During my stay at Swartz High School, Ramanathapuram, my relationship with the teacher grew beyond the teacher and the people, and I learned how I could exercise enormous influence over the events of my life. Teacher Ayatharai Solomon used to say, to succeed in life and achieve results, you must understand and master three mighty forces: desire, belief, and expectation. Ayatharai Solomon, who later became reverend, taught me that before anything I wanted to happen, I should have a desire and work intensely. If one works intensely, it is absolutely certain that the desire will be fulfilled. It's a great message for all the students in that age. Later, while I was in St. Joseph's College, Trichinopoly, it's a SJ institution, Catholic institution, I was fortunate to be taught Shakespeare by Reverend Father T.N. Sequeira. People used to say even Shakespeare will be moved if he hears his lecture. It was true. He was also our new hostel warden. Every day Father Sequeira used to make a night visit to the hostels, and it was called Father's Visit. One day I recall my roommate Sachidanandan was not well. When Father Sequeira met him, he asked him what was the problem. He told him that he was having a headache. For immediate relief, Father took aspirin from his long rope he had, and gave him the tablet. With concern, he immediately sent him to the doctor. On the next day, Father T.N. Sequeira visited my next roommate, Abraham, gave an inland letter to him since he was not writing to his parents. This was a beautiful experience of learning for me. I am sure the students of St. Thomas, students of the college here, St. Mar Augustus College, is indeed benefiting such type of a care from their teachers. This was a beautiful experience for me. Now let us see, friends, few great personalities who are always remembered and celebrated by humanity for their unique contribution. Because I want to see every student should dream to be a unique. Every student to dream to be a unique. Now, what is unique you? I am talking to you at a subject unique you now. Dear friends, look up. Now, look up. You see the light, isn't it? Light and bulb, you see. Whom do you remember? Whom do you remember? You are remembering Thomas Alva Edison for his unique contribution towards the invention of electric bulb and his electric lighting system. Now, every day, you will hear the aircraft flying, every alternate day it will be flying. When you hear the sound of the aircraft, whom do you remember? You're very good, you are remembering the Wright brothers. When the telephone bell rings, you remember a person. Alexander Graham Bell, you remember. There was a great scientist, Indian scientist, who was traveling, who was in a voyage, sea voyage, from London to Calcutta. When he reached Calcutta, the sun was shining, and he looked at the sea, horizon was blue, and the sky was blue, horizon, the sea was blue. He asked a question, why sky is blue and why sea is blue? Then he has to work very hard for 5 years to find out an answer. He got an answer, he got a Nobel Prize. Can you think of a person? Very good. Sir Sri Raman discovered, because he is scattering of light. Due to the scattering of light, the phenomena what he has seen, for that it took him 5 years. So friends, you have, now I am going to talk to you another person. He is Chandrasekhar Subramaniam. What did he do, Chandrasekhar Subramaniam? Can you think of? He discovered what is called Chandra limit. Chandra limit, small equation. Using that equation, you can find out how long the sun will shine. Okay? If sun does not shine, what happens? Earth will be in trouble. Okay? So by that equation, we can find out now about 10 billion years sun will shine by thermonuclear reaction. 5 billion is over, another 5 billion are there, so you don't need to worry. And he discovered Chandra limit and also black hole. And also black hole, he is remembered as a person who discovered the black hole. So friends, now there is one lady who got two Nobel Prizes. Can you think of? Madame Curie got two Nobel Prizes. So friends, now you just see. When I said the bulb and light, immediately you can say Thomas Alva Edison. When I said aircraft flying, immediately you are in a position to say it is the Wright brothers. Bell rings, Alexander Graham Bell comes in front of you. When backscattering of light, immediately you can think of Sir C.V. Raman. And similarly, as Chandrasekhar Subramaniam, you can recall for his discovery of Chandra limit. So why do you remember all these people? Why do you remember all these? Because they are unique. The question is whether you want to be unique. Let us see that. Friends, I have so far met about 13 million youth in the country. I learned every youth wants to be unique. That is you. But hear me what I'm saying. But the world all around you is doing its best day and night to make you just everybody else. Okay? When your parents say, see the neighbor's children, how they are doing fantastically in education. You come to school and college, they will say, your teachers may say, why not be first, fifth ranks like the one, second, two, third, four, third, fourth, fifth rank. So everybody want you to make somebody else. So, but you want to be unique. So the challenge, what is the challenge? If you want to be unique, that's a challenge. The challenge, my young friends, is that you have to fight the hardest battle which any human being can ever imagine to fight and never stop fighting until you arrive at your destined place, that is unique you. Now, I have given you to fight for the unique. What is the tool? All the eight people, the unique people I told you, they had four unique qualities. What are the unique qualities? Number one, they had a great aim. Small aim is a crime. But these people had the great aim they had, number one. Number two, they continuously acquire the knowledge through great books, to great human beings, and through great teachers. They were continuously acquire the knowledge. Third one, of course, hard work. You have to sweat. They sweated. And fourth one is the perseverance. They are not afraid of the problem. They will become the chairperson of the, they will captain of the problem and defeat the problem and succeed. That's called perseverance. So if you want to become a unique, what you derive from the unique people are four qualities. Number one, great aim. Number two, acquiring the knowledge. Number three, number four, perseverance. That means any problem comes, you will not allow the problem to be your captain. You should become the captain of the problem, defeat the problem and succeed. Okay? So friends, now you have to succeed in life. And I want to recite something, a poem written long time back. Will you recite, all of you? Are you ready? Yes. I am. You're not eaten for some time. I am. Born with potential. I am born with goodness and trust. I am born with ideas and dreams. I am born with greatness. I am born with confidence. I am born with wings. I am born with wings. So, I am not meant for crawling because I have wings. I will fly. I will fly. I will fly. How many of you want to fly and a unique person? How many of you want to become unique and fly and fly? And all of you. Except first few rows. Oh, okay. Very good. Dear friends, it is nice all of you to see now you want to become a unique fellow. You know how to become a unique fellow or unique girl now, okay? You know about it? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, now I'm going to tell you, how do you evolve? How do you evolve a happy home? Every one of us want to live in a happy home? Yes,
yes
isn't it?
Yes.
We want to have a happy home. Now, what is happy home? I'm going to give you an equation, okay? You have to carefully hear me what the equation. Happy home is equal to a spiritual house plus a happy mother plus a transparent home, that means transparent father, plus a green home, plus green home. Tell me the equation. Happy home is equal to spiritual house, happy mother, happy and transparent father. Fourth one, green home. Now let us look at how the spiritual house should be, okay? Spiritual house. I'm going to give you a job. All the students, you have to take it up very carefully and hear me. Spiritual house. Friends, let us look at a small family home with father, mother, and a son and a daughter, or two sons or two daughters. In this home, both parents yearn. I visualize in this little home, a little home library with at least 10 great books you can afford. And in this home, parents have inculcated reading habit. Now, the first few row gets into action, okay? First few row, you have to get into action. So, what I'm saying, parents and teachers, I visualize in this little home, a little home library with at least 10 great books in this home parents. The parents have to inculcate the reading habit among their children by reading books during breakfast or during dinner. The whole family should be together at least one meal so that they communicate and discuss freely. When they are all together at the dining table, the mother or the father takes a book from the little home library, narrates a story of ethical moral values where the children participate in the discussion and offer their comments. Such a reading habit triggers the child to read the book in detail and collect more information on such stories, which put into practice in their day and night. So some children may also carry the information to their school so that communicate. This is how the seeding of reading habits can be inculcated among the young minds. In addition, I visualized a little prayer room where every morning or night the whole family, including the children, prays and offer their thanks to the Almighty for receiving blessings. Now, how many of you students, inside the hall and also outside the hall, you will ensure you have a little home library? How many of you? All of you. I'm very happy that a home library is emerges. Now, first equation, the first one, spiritual home, spiritual house we saw. Next one, mother happy. Now, repeat with me, all of you, all the students, you repeat with me. From today onwards, you guys not eaten for 2 days. From today onwards,
I will make
my mother happy. If my mother is happy,
my home is happy.
If my home is happy,
societies are happy.
If societies are happy,
Kerala is happy.
How many of you will make your mother happy? All of you. Except first few rows. Okay. Now, a transparent home, okay? Next aspect in the equation is a transparent father, transparent home. It's a very tough job, okay? Friends, I said we belong to a society of 200 million families. Billion people live there. Every family, number of members are there. Dear and friends, I have a mission for the youth of the nation. That is, daughter or son or the family. Friends, every one of you assembled here will know, after all, corruption emanates in few homes, not all homes, few homes. It is estimated 30% of our Indian homes may be non-transparent. That means approximately 60 million houses may be corrupt. In a non-transparent home, you may be son or daughter, can sense it, you can sense it, yes or no, can sense it and persuade the father not to become a victim of non-transparency using their love and affection. You have young people, in case unfortunately your home is not transparent, you have a great tool. What the great tool? Love and the affection to your parents. Similarly, they have. So use that so that you can make the home transparent. Can you? My conscience says compared to any law against corruption, definitely this movement of the youth against corruption will be extremely effective. After all, the law, what it will do against corruption, it will fill the jails, okay? Prisons, it will fill it up. But what I'm saying, apart from a great law, we need moral guide. The children is a big brigade, youth brigade for anti-corruption in the homes. If you do it, we have a beautiful India, at least in 2 decades' time. Now, friends, what is the green? Next one? Green home. How many of you know photosynthesis? Photosynthesis. All of you know photosynthesis. You know, by photosynthesis process, a mature tree absorbs 24 kilogram of carbon dioxide and lets out about 12 kilogram of oxygen. It lets out. Imagine every one of you near a house, around the house, or a park, if you plant 5 trees and nurture, what the amount of you will be taking India to a green India situation. How many of you will do? You have plant 5 trees and nurture. How many of you? Will you do, all of you? Okay. Now, friends, I would like to ask you, what you would like to be remembered for? In conclusion, you have to evolve yourself and shape your life. You should write it on a page. Today, you have to write it on a page. That page may be a very important page in the book of human history. And you will be remembered for creating that one page in the history of the nation, whether that page is the page of invention, page of innovation, or the page of discovery, or the page of creating societal change, or a page of removing the poverty, or the page of fighting injustice, or the planning and executing mission of network of rivers. I'd be very happy if you young people of this college, Augustine College of Ramapuram, if you could write this page and mail to me, some of you, if you mail to me, my mail apj@abdulkalam.com, apj@abdulkalam.com. If you write to me, I will correspond with you. If I get good ideas, I will send you some good books also. My greetings to all the members of Mar Agustino College, Ramapuram, in Kottayam district. My best wishes to all of you for success in your education mission. May God bless you all, friends. Now, for the student inside the hall and outside the hall, I have a oath for the students. You are ready? 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 Or hungry? Ready? Okay. I will have a goal. Work hard. Achieve that goal. I realize that small aim is a crime. I will work with integrity. and succeed with integrity. I will be good member of my family, good member of the society, good member of the nation, and a good member of the world. I will always try to save or better someone's life without any discrimination of caste, creed, language, religion, or state. Wherever I am, that is, a thought will always come to my mind. What can I give? What can I give? What can I give? You'll be the happiest fellow if you have that idea of what can I give, okay? You give. You have many things to give. You don't need money. I will always protect and enhance and dignity of every human life without any bias. I will always work for clean planet Earth and clean energy. Will you? As a youth of my nation, as a youth of my nation, I will work and work with courage, achieve the success in all my tasks, and enjoy the success of others. Enjoy? Enjoy? I am as young as my faith, as old as my doubt. Hence, I will light up then the lamp of faith in my heart. My national flag, flies in my heart, and I'll bring glory to my nation. Thank you, friends. You are all very smart children. Very good. Okay. Anyone can ask 5 questions. Anyone, okay? Anyone. Get up, anyone. Give a mic to them.
Sir, my name is Amal Tom George.
Which class you are studying?
I am studying in 12th class.
12th?
Yes.
12th class?
Yes.
What the subject you have taken?
Computer science.
Computer science.
Yes.
What's your dream?
Sir, my dream is to be a cyber warrior for the Indian Army.
Cyber warrior?
Yes.
Fantastic fellow you are. Very good. Okay,
thanks.
What is the question?
Sir, my question is, our democracy is facing a crisis of conquering the mandate from the government using tactics by the vote beggars. Sir, will you give a suggestion to create a culture for tomorrow's electors as to elect leaders from the minds of India who will uplift India?
Now, I personally believe the youth of India are nearly about 600 million people, 60%, okay? Youth of India. You have got one power. What is that power? What is the power? You have got a vote, okay?
Yes,
you can elect persons. So it is youth should decide to elect the right person to parliament and assembly, then everything will be all right. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Okay, sir.
You have the power. You have the power.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, myself, I'm Sanju Sani.
Where are you?
Here, sir.
Where?
Sir, I represent the commerce department of our college.
Where?
Commerce department of this college.
What did you do? What class you are?
I'm doing my final year BCom.
BCom?
Yes, sir.
After studying BCom, what is your dream?
I want to be the nation's most remembered, most respected and revered politician.
You want to be a politician?
Yes, sir.
You are a good fellow. Tell me, as a politician, what will you do?
Sir, as a politician?
Only one thing you tell me, your primary thing. I want to hear because I want to see young people join politics, okay?
Sir,
you tell me, what will you do?
So what I see these days is that the government the leaders of our nation drives a vehicle.
Don't question leader. What will you do?
I'll definitely act for the benefit of the common man.
What benefit of the common man?
Common man.
Very, very vague. The lot of things common man has got the problem, poverty.
Yes,
common
sir.
Man has got, he has to undergo the torture of corruption.
Sir,
okay, what's your question?
Sir, my question is about Kudankulam.
Yeah.
Sir, it has been a very flaring question these days. Sir, Germany has decided to phase out their nuclear power projects by the year 2022. USA and Russia has not initiated any nuclear programs for the past 2 to 3 decades. Sir, do we need such a project such as Kudankulam in our nation?
My friend,
yes, sir.
I'm in the field, okay?
Yes, sir.
You are the right fellow. Now, it is like this. The world has got 542 nuclear power plants. Remember, world has got
542
nuclear power plants generating electricity. Second one, I'm just returning from China. China have decided to put up about 70 nuclear power plants next 5 years' time. Okay? Now, the Germany one is closing is not important because they have sufficient power. Another thing I want to tell you, I have visited all the nuclear power plant, particularly seashore nuclear power plant, and the type of what Japan experienced, combination of tsunami and earthquake, and also there is no radiation death there. There is no radiation death. Only the accident because of tsunami and earthquake, building collapses. So with reference to what happened in Japan, I reviewed all the nuclear power plant in the seashore area, and we have a 3 safety lock. Any radiation and internally it will be consumed. So nuclear power plant in India, I will say, is very safe. Second thing is, you know, when you come to this college, Augustinos College, how do you come? You come in the two-wheeler, sometime you come in the four-wheeler, sometime buses, something you come. Remember, every liter of oil you use, petrol you use, you generate 2.3 kilogram of carbon dioxide. The whole world is trying to make nearly 30 billion ton carbon dioxide put every year, and the earth is being damaged. So I am promoting what is called energy independence. Energy independence means going away from fossil fuel, go for solar power, wind power, nuclear power, and biofuel and hydropower. Okay?
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Hi, sir. My name is Cluster Jonas.
Where are you?
I am from Arvindra.
Now, where are you, I am asking. Lift your hand. Okay. What class you are studying?
I am studying at 12th.
12. What subject you have taken?
Biology science.
Eh?
Biology science.
Biology science.
Yeah.
Why? What? Where? Next what?
Sir, I aim to be an IAS officer.
Biology science and IAS officer.
Yeah.
How? Very good. Very nice. Okay.
So my ultimate aim is to be an IAS officer, or otherwise I will be in the medical field.
Okay, okay. Wish you all the best. What the question?
Okay, sir. The literacy rate of India is rising up, while at the same time, environmental literacy declines. How does this environmental illiteracy affect the economic and scientific fields of India, and how can we control it?
Actually, there is what is a beautiful question. There is a new science coming up, what is called convergence of sciences or convergence of technologies. Bioscience, information science, nanoscience, and environmental science. Okay, all the four are coming together. So I have recommended for India, for our country, we have 200 million houses, okay? 200 million houses. All of them should go for solar-powered houses, okay? Solar-powered houses. And it will become, just now I am returning from Gujarat, they have got one place, 242 megawatt power charging a place, and also total state has got 700 megawatt. Kerala has got a high potential to go for solar power. Every roof of your home, and can be definitely 6 million houses should have solar powered houses, it will become, okay? Then you have a clean in Kerala that will lead to clean India, okay?
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay.
Hello, sir. Hello.
May I continue?
Where are you? Yes, yes.
Sir, my name is Gopika. I'm from Chavra International School. I do not know whether my question suits the occasion, but still I want to ask you. Today is the 4th anniversary of the 26/11 Mumbai terrorist attack. And we read in the newspapers recently that we have spent crores of money for the safety and security for the protection of a notorious criminal like Ajmal Kasab. Sir, don't you feel that it was a national wasteful expenditure?
Well, what you see, you have voted for democratic country, okay? In democracy, we have to go a certain process. Now, we have to ensure how the terrorism, technologically, strategically, we can eliminate. I have given a plan that a 5-point action on anti-terrorism, okay? So you go to my website, www.abdulkalam.com, you put anti-terrorism, you'll get the details, okay? Next question.
Hello, sir. My name is Dheeraj. I'm a second year BCom degree student of Madras News College. Sir, a few days ago, the Times of India reported that you believe peer pressure on students is a threat to nation's development. So what do you think is the reason for it? Is it the present educational system?
No, I didn't get you. What?
Sir,
what is the question?
Okay, sir.
Well, forget about who has reported. What is the question?
Sir, you believe that peer pressure on students is a peer pressure on students.
Pressure?
So pressure on students.
Peer pressure. Okay.
Pressure on students is a threat to nation's development.
Yeah.
I mean, parents, teachers, everyone pressurize our students to score high marks so that we can get good jobs and pursue high in our lives. So why do you believe that it's a threat to our nation's development? So is it the present educational system or is it the attitudes of the people around us?
No, I personally believe, after all, parents have certain, Indian parents have got certain love and affection toward their children, okay?
Yes,
so they borrow money from the banks, they educate their children, okay? And naturally, they want to see the boys and girls, they go to certain type of education so that their life will be prosperous, okay?
Okay,
the intention very good for parents' point of view. But I am advocating a point, what is called a science cadre or humanity cadre. This cadre, just like IAS, that this cadre of people after BSc, MSc, they can go for PhD, and they will be assured for 400 position be available in a regular, in the institution like Atomic Energy, ISRO, DRDO, and CSIR, and some of the industries, academic institution. So the grade is there, then parents and children also love to take some subject what they love, okay? Okay, friends, so I have to go, but I want to tell you, my mail note down, apj@abdulkalam.com, apj@abdulkalam.com, and if you send a mail to me with a question, I will give an answer. And also, if you want an autograph, anyone of you want an autograph, No. That's okay. That's why I'm saying. So autograph also, you send a message for the same mail that you need autograph, you will get with autograph and photograph. Okay? You will get. Okay. Now, can I take the principal? This for your library, sir.
Thank you, sir. Yes.
Thank you, sir, for reminding about the uniqueness of character that each individual should inculcate.
Give light and the darkness will disappear by itself.
Let me call upon Sri K. M. Mani, the Honorable Minister for Finance and Law, our very own political acumen, for his felicitations.
Your Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Your Excellency Joseph Kalarangad, Bishop of Palai, Your Excellency Mr. M.N. Jaikie, former Governor of Kerala, Meghalaya, Dr. V.J. Joseph, Principal, Reverend Father George Nyarakunnel, Manager, and my dear friends. I deem it a great privilege to be here to participate in the reception accorded to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam by the St. Augustine's College. His visit to this college is a historical event. It will go down in the history of St. Augustine's College in red letters, golden letters. May I take this opportunity to extend to His Excellency for having honored this institution by his esteemed visit. And I congratulate the principal and the management of this school, of this college, for having provided an opportunity to the students of this college to have an opportunity to see His Excellency Dr. Abdul Kalam and to touch him and to interact with the former president. I thank also the management of the teachers, the students, because I know within a short span of 1.5 decades, St. Augustine's College has emerged as one of the best institutions of the state. And my congratulations. Then Mr. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is popularly known as a missile man of India. He has two types of missiles. One missile is the first missile he designed and devised and sent it from surface to the space during the Pokhran second test. The second missile is the missile he sent your heart. The second missile is the missile during his speech he spent his words and thoughts. It has reached out to your mind and brain. It has penetrated your heart. That will may change life and your lifestyle. That is a great man, this visionary, the greatest scientist, the greatest statesman, the greatest luminary, the greatest visionary. I will also join all of you with to felicitate Dr. Abdul Kalam. My dear students, Dr. Kalam is a visionary. His Vision 220 is a research document, is a research book which for our developmental march towards 20, for the India's developmental march towards 20. And he has presented another book for Kerala, Kerala Focus. That book contains a 10-point program. And I am very happy to bring to the kind attention of Dr. Abdul Kalam that some of his suggestions have been carried out by the government of Kerala, some are under implementation. And he has a wonderful project. Dr. Kalam has a project. What can you give? That is the project designed for the students. What can you give? We may be talking what we will get, what I will get. But the one thing, what we will get, we should think what I can give, what we can give to the society, to the nation. Let me cut short, my dear students, after completion of our studies, when you leave out this college, when you leave out this campus, you come out with a deepened insight, with a wider horizon, with a new philosophy of life. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We invite our manager, very Reverend Dr. George Nyarakunnel, to present Dr. Kalam with a memento as a token of our gratitude.
Amen. I request Dr. M.M. Jacob, the former governor of Meghalaya, to felicitate the gathering.
The chief guest today, His Excellency Mr. Sri Abdul Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam. His Excellency the Bishop of Palai, Kalarangat. Dr. Nyarakunnail, the manager of the institution. Dr. Joseph, the principal. And Vatican MLA of the area. And the Finance Minister of Kerala, His Excellency Mr. K.M. Mani. Ladies, gentlemen, and dear students. I thought I will make a speech today. When I talked to the president, I realized that he is running short of time and my speech is not at all going to be incomplete because I can get other opportunities here to talk to you. So, ningade ellam anubhavathodu koodi Sri Abdul Kalaminte Chengannur program thagarnu povathirikkan nammale pole kaathirikkunna aalukalanu avade 3 manikku adheyathin meeting vechittundu ivide idu vijayikkunnathu. One thing matram, I thought, I must mention one thing. This college, during the short span of period, has become a very tempting point of attraction for students to come from all parts of India and even outside. Why? Because the scholastic leadership, scholarly leadership of the Bishop of Palai, Kalarangat, and also the manager of the institution, a knowledgeable Father Vikar, these are all, and efficient teachers and principal, these are all the points that drawing the people, students from various parts of this college. And we are thankful for all of you to come and attend today's function and receive Dr. Abdul Kalam in a most humble, courteous way. I thank you once again for this wonderful opportunity. And I cut short my speech because he has to go. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I call upon our principal, Dr. Vijay Joseph, to propose a vote of thanks.
His Excellency Mr. Joseph Kalarangat, the President of the meeting, the Chief Guest Paradirakna, His Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Sri K.M. Mani, Honorable Minister for Finance, Dr. M.M. Jacob, former Governor of Meghalaya, Reverend Dr. George Nyarakunnail, our beloved manager, representatives of local bodies, especially Sri Joseph Adigan MLA, Reverend Fathers, Sisters, members of the PTA, Trust Board and Parish Council, invited guests, dear colleagues, students and friends. Maragastinas College is extremely fortunate to have Faradrakna Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the former President of India, in our midst today. Known the world over as a scientist and visionary, he has traveled the length and breadth of the country, inspiring the youth to dream great. He has constantly been exhorting the youth to mobilize the resources and dreams to make India a developed country in the next few decades. He has shared his dreams with us today, and our students, I hope, will imbibe the spirit to aim high in life. With thankfulness to Almighty God for the graces showered on me and this institution in the past, let me come to my duty. First of all, I thank the President of the meeting, His Excellency Mr. Joseph Kalarangat, Bishop of Palai, our patron and mentor. He has always been our tower of strength and an inspiring force behind all our activities. Thank you, Your Excellency, for your presence and words of encouragement. His Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has been generous enough to come over to our college for his interactive session. As I have already mentioned, he is a visionary leader breathing fire into the minds of the youth of India. We are thankful to him for his inspiring presence and words of wisdom. In the name of all those assembled here, I thank him for his generous gesture, presence and involvement in this program. Thank you, sir, very much. Thank you, sir. Sri K.M. Mani, Honorable Minister for Finance, has always been part of this institution. Thank you, sir, most sincerely for the honor you have extended to us with your presence. Dr. M.M. Jacob, former Governor of Meghalaya, has been gracious enough to favor us with his presence. I thank him most sincerely for his generosity and presence. I would be failing in my duty if I don't extend a word of thanks to our beloved manager, Reverend Dr. George Nyarakunnel, our friend, philosopher, and guide in all our activities. I acknowledge his dedication and vision and thank him for his presence, involvement, and guidance. I also recall with gratitude our former managers, the founder manager, Reverend Father Augustine Berimattam, the hardcore visionary, Reverend Father Siriya Kunnel, and Reverend Father Matthew Neriveli, who sustained the growth momentum of this institution. I acknowledge their presence and thank all of them for gracing this occasion with their presence. I also express my sincere gratitude to Reverend Fathers, Reverend Sisters, members of the Trust Board and Parish Council, PTA, Police and Fire Force Authorities, and other officials of various departments, media personnel and other public figures, especially Sri Joseph Adigan MLA, who have been kind enough to honour us with their presence. Especially, I am thankful to Mr. R. Prasannan, Senior Correspondent of the Week, New Delhi, for facilitating this memorable event. Thank you, one and all. But for the unstinted support and wholehearted cooperation of my colleagues and my students, this program would have lost much of its tantalizing beauty. Thank you for your graceful participation in the program, for the decorum and commitment to the ethos of Mar Agustinos. Above all, I raise my heart in thankfulness to God for all the blessings showered on me and this great temple of learning in its long, arduous journey to nurture the course of higher education in this part of the state. Thanking you all from the bottom of my heart, once again, let me conclude. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Please rise for the national anthem.
Janaganamana Adinayaka Jayahe Bharada Bhagya Vidhata Punjab, Sindh, Gujarat, Maratha, Dravida, Utkala, Banga, Vindhya, Himachala, Yamuna, Ganga, Uchala, Jaladi, Taranga, Tava Shubha Name Jage, Tava Shubha Ashisha Mage, Gage, Tava Jaya Gadha. ಜನಗಣ ಮಂಗಳದಾಯಕ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಭಾರತ ಭಾಗ್ಯ ವಿಧಾದ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ ಹೇ ಜಯ 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 ಹೇ
ವಿ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ ಅಗಸ್ತಿನಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಕಾಲೇಜಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೌಡ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಯರ್ ಇನ್ವಿಗರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್ for presenting a panacea for the ailments of our nation. Corruption, poverty, terrorism, whatever may be the issue, the solution lies in the happy home, where the spiritual house, happy mother, transparent father, and green home together promotes a better society. We thank you, sir, for inspiring us to be unique. Thank you.